Here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. And then we've got Kamal.
Hi, thank you. So, yeah, I'm Kamal. I'm from Shimla, running a company called DataBlair. So, we are working in a physical cyberspace where we are providing our products for power industry, where we are covering various products for solar, wind, and hydro. And on this session, I'm here to listen to a brand called Atul
All right, that's interesting.
Puri.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Yeah, Manoj.
Hello. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi. My name is Manoj Kumar. I'm from Delhi, and I'm
All right.
running a placement agency. And I just want to listen to you. But
Fantastic. Thank you for coming in.
Thanks.
Yeah. Charudatta.
Thank you for this opportunity to understand this. People connected. People shared this. Link with me that you are conducting this session. So I do bits into helping companies use technology. So I was very keen to understand the how the digital transformation strategy that can be implemented, and want to learn more about it, how it can happen.
Fantastic. Thanks for joining in. And you're from Bombay, right? Mumbai.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Pritha.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
I am in the banking industry. I am security officer. I am planning to shift, so I am looking at, and my sister is also into started a business. So I thought I will learn what are the how the digital technology can be used for marketing and other things.
Awesome. And I hope your employer is not listening to this video
No, sir.
today.
And I have got it this link from IECCCI group where
All
you had
right.
shared the link.
Yeah. Okay. So you're from the armed forces or connected to them.
Yes, sir. I am from the armed forces, sir.
Fantastic. Thanks for joining in.
Thanks, sir.
Rajendra. Yeah. Rajendra. Rajendra, are you there? Okay. Ahuja Saab.
Yeah, Atul.
Yeah, please introduce yourself. And thanks for joining in. I know you were supposed to be elsewhere. And you've taken time out.
Yeah,
I really
yeah, yeah.
appreciate this.
Thank you. So that's why my video is off. So anyway, I'm GS Abuja. I'm a chartered accountant by qualification and practice. I've been associated now with e-growth last, I think this is the third year going, almost since the beginning it started. So it is something very good to be associated with, and thanks Atul for the energy and the passion which you put in, because whenever we get little, so to say, dila, you start something which we get back on the track. Thanks so much.
Awesome. Thank you. Thanks for such kind words. Have you got Vinay with us?
या हाय नमस्ते दोस्तों.
नमस्ते जी.
आप सभी को मकर संक्रांति की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं और बधाइयां.
आपको भी.
धन्यवाद. मेरा बेसिकली बैकग्राउंड फाइनेंस से है, और
हाँ
मैं 23 साल कॉरपोरेट वर्ल्ड में काम कर चुका हूँ,
हाँ जी.
जिसमें से HDFC ग्रुप, आदित्य बिरला ग्रुप एंड सिग्ना मणिपाल में.
हाँ अभी क्या
करेंटली
कर रहे हैं
मैं
आप और किस शहर से हैं?
हाँ करेंटली मैं क्रिप्टो ब्लॉकचेन माइनिंग पे ही काम कर रहा हूँ. एंड प्रेजेंटली अभी जो हूँ मुंबई से हूँ, लेकिन एट प्रेजेंट मैं कोलकाता हूँ.
ऑलराइट फैंटास्टिक.
सो जस्ट जानना चाह रहा था कि आप लोग डिजिटल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन में क्या नई चीज है, तो एटलीस्ट यू हैव टू बी अपडेटेड ऑल द टाइम.
ठीक है, बहुत बेहतर. सो वील ट्राई एंड आंसर दिस टुडे.
या श्योर. थैंक यू.
या सो भैरवी.
हाय.
Yeah, please introduce yourself.
I'm Vaidhavi Shah from Pune. I'm educator and consultant. So it's about me.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for joining in. We also have Gaurav with us.
Hi. How are you, sir?
I'm doing good.
So actually, I'm Gaurav Gupta. I am heading a software company. We are only digital transformation for government organizations.
So, fantastic. And where are you based, Gaurav?
Hyderabad.
Okay,
so we are doing a lot of in facial recognition technology, and so we are automated so many government softwares. It is used by public as well right now.
Okay, so I can see we have people from at least 6 cities: Hyderabad, Shimla, Delhi, Mumbai, Pune, and Gurgaon. So thanks all. If I've missed somebody's introduction, I'm really, we'll take it up later. If we have some time, let's start. So are you all ready for this transformative session? If yes, then put yes in the chat box. Let me see how many of you are really excited about it. Just one yes so far. Fantastic. All right. So Preetha is so excited that she's only said S. All right. Great. Thank you. And I missed Advait's introduction. Advait is my right hand. Advait, can you please introduce yourself before we move further?
Yes. So, please. So good morning, everyone.
And if it works, please switch on your video as well.
Yeah, actually, bandwidth ka thoda sa issue hai.
No worries.
Isse maine janbuchke video off kiya.
Yes.
So, good morning, everyone. We are here today to receive some introduction about the digital transformation. Now, hume yaad hai ki jab kuch saal pehle, a few decades back, when the first level of digital transformation came in, you know, in the form of computers and all that. So, all those people and all the companies, you know, which had, which were able to pivot themselves soon, they had survived in a miraculous way and they are still growing. And companies jo ki us time pe apne aap ko pivot nahi kar pai thi, you know, they struggled a lot and some of them, died away. So abhi, I think this is the third wave of the next digital transformation, which has already started. AI is here, machine learning is here, right? Web 3.0 is about to come and metaverse is already here. So the rules of the game are changing completely. And, you know, that is why this introduction session is very important. And I think if we can really imbibe ki yahan par jo next level, jo third wave of digital transformation hai, jo abhi aa raha hai, usme kya kya hone wala hai, then, you know, we are ready to take our business through this transformation wave in a very successful way. So I think that is the core importance of today's class and also the core importance of the session, the workshop, you know, which we will be doing on the 28th and 29th of January from all the experts which are coming all across the country. So this is what I wanted to say.
All right. So Advait, he manages the community at eGrowth and he has been instrumental in putting up this show together. All right. And so we've got exact 1 hour and 15 minutes. I invite you to please schedule your life such that you're here till the end. Our promise for today is that we'll be talking about digital transformation strategy. We are not talking about how will you do it, but we are talking about what can be the larger impact. So we'll keep it as interactive as possible. Okay, so to begin with, all of you are most welcome. I understand today is Makar Sankranti. You would have been having festivities at your home, cooking some delicious food or eating it, planning to go out and maybe flying kites as well. In spite of that, you're here. I really appreciate this. Thank you. Now, the slideshow is not working very well, so we'll have to do with less of these animations. All right. So here's a little bit about me. I spent around 25 years in the corporate space and then went on my own working with small businesses. So this photo that you see in the middle, this was 2007 in Hawaii. When I saw this car, I felt in love with this car. And I thought that all the business owners should have a car of this kind. This one is a Mustang, which was launched in India in 2016. It is a Ford brand. All right. And have been on this journey for a very long time. I've worked with organizations like CDAC, SIFI, HID, United Technologies, MSM, and also with GaadiFix, which was a startup. Like most of us, I also picked up some awards along the journey. And I participated in a program in IIM Bangalore on competitive marketing strategy. I am a Rotarian. I've published two books by the name Golf Mastering Business Success and Opportunity, The Journey from U to Yes. I have published two business models. One is called eGrowth, which is the growth framework. The second one is the leverage model, which is about how to design your business. I also happen to be the chapter director for Startup Grind for Gurgaon, which is the world's largest startup ecosystem. So this was a little bit about me. Let's move further. Now, why am I here? It's because I want more people to be successful in what they do, whether they're business owners or they're employed by somebody or they don't work anymore. So whatsoever success means for you, I'm committed to help you with that. I help you design your success. Now, success can be a business for you. It can be your employment for you, or it can be doing nothing for you. This is all what I do. This is what all what I've been doing for past 8 years. And I'll continue to do this further. Now, the promises for today. We will have a look at digital transformation in business, how it has been happening for some time. We'll go through 9 principles on digital transformation, 3 secrets of leveraged business, and you will also have an opportunity to create a future in this space by participating in something called as Unfold Your Greatness. So if you're excited about it, let's put in the chat box, yes, I'm excited. So I will deliver with as much excitement as I hear in the chat box. Okay, one. Okay, so I'll be just as excited. Okay, Vinay is also excited. 2, 3. All right, fantastic. So now I have some reason to continue further. Okay. So today's topic is digital transformation. And why digital transformation? Would somebody like to share? You can please unmute and share why do you think digital transformation is important today? And what do you understand by the word digital transformation? We'll hear from 2 of you. And fastest finger first.
I will take this opportunity.
Yeah, first. Please.
Yes. So digital transformation is everywhere, especially if we need to take our business into the automation mode. We need to understand the digital transformation as business owners, right? And apart from that, if we are running a business in digital space, we need to know many, many things related to marketing, sales, all those perspective, as well as how we can process, automate our processes and systems for our customers as well, right? So this is what the digital transformation is important for.
Awesome. So, thanks, Kamal. Who goes next? Tick, tick 1, tick, tick 2, tick, tick 3. All right, so you get to speak in the next opportunity, all right? So in the next couple of slides, I'll share with you my perspective on digital transformation of this world. All right. I would have ideally liked to show this with animation, but that will not be possible because there is some challenge at my end. So this is how the world looked in 2000. Okay. We used to shake hands and do businesses. The telephones used to be big and they used to be wired. We still used to send letters through Department of Posts. The World Wide Web had just about started coming in. We used to have something called as Yellow Pages to promote our businesses. Newspaper still was very important in our business. This was the world which we called as the brick and mortar world. In fact, we started calling it the brick and mortar world later on, but this is how the world was. And then in about 15 years, the world evolved to become a digital world. There's somebody who was talking about cryptocurrency. So by 2015, Bitcoin had come and it was like done and dusted, the first round. If you see all these logos, most of them are not the same now. So Instagram does not look like this now. Google does not look like this now. At the rate or email had started gaining currency. YouTube was there, Pinterest was there. We had blogs and Paytm had started appearing, was still not the main currency. But yes, Karlo Dunya Mutthi Mein was there. Mobile phone has started gaining currency. And today, 8 years later, from the digital world, we have progressed to the connected world, where practically everything is connected. Today, the world is defined by four characters, which is FANG. So you might want to write it in the chat box so that you remember. It is FANG. F stands for Facebook, A is Amazon, N is Netflix, and G is Google. These four platforms today have the maximum amount of data on this planet. These four platforms know much more about us than we know ourselves. And if you think this is true, then please write in the chat box, "Oh, Teri." Yeah, Vinay, I have a challenge. I'm not able to use the full screen because if I use the full screen, I'm not able to move on to the next screen. You'll not be able to see it. That's why we're using it like this. And then there's a lot more which has changed. We've got Apple and Android who are ruling the mobile phone industry today. Zomato, Blinkit, they deliver stuff at our place. Oyo and Make My Trip, they provide us the hotels and transportation. Uber and Ola, they've taken away the cars. Okay. So for practically, yes, so good. We've got some Oteris. Okay. So practically everything has come in our hand. Today, all of us are in a stand of handcuffs. And we are handcuffed to our mobile phones. We cannot live without our mobile phone. This is the reality of today. So now I want some of you to share what are your reflections from these three slides. Have you been seeing or dealing with this transformation in your life? Let's have three people share.
Yes, I think there are a lot of transformations since I think 1990s itself, actually, from the internet, when the internet is introduced till the level what we are right now, right? So not only in the daily life, also business side as well, right? So I think a mobile has played a tremendous role along with the internet in the mobile phone, actually, right? So all the apps are getting interconnected. So our life is totally dependent on mobiles right now in terms of daily living as well as business transaction wise, every aspect actually. So I don't know how far it will go further. Now it can read our mind as well, right?
Absolutely.
So we don't know like how fast and how things will move, like in terms of many aspects of life.
Awesome.
It will be very rapid as well, right?
Definitely. Who else?
Charudatta here. It has brought a very interesting dilemma for a lot of manufacturing companies, because particularly they were always conventional, very averse to the technology, but the lockdown made everybody to go online and have some people at least working remotely. So they have been, they managed to do that for about a year or so until the time people came back, and now everything is normal. So there is a huge struggle in small and medium sector regarding whether they want to be with the old ways, they want to go back to the old ways, or they want to keep using the technology. I think that's a very interesting phase and a very interesting struggle people are going through.
I think you have to embrace the technology actually later on, right? There's no chance about that. Right?
All right. Yeah. Thanks, Charu and Gaurav.
I would like to add something here.
Yeah, please.
2023, now it's not FANG, now it's MANG.
Okay.
So Meta has changed from Facebook now. So MANG is new word. And second, we are getting into new revolution of decentralizing the data ownership through Web3.
Absolutely.
So our data is now ours, and we will be earning money out of our data as well. So this revolution is happening in 2023 as well.
Absolutely.
Yes.
So while we would want to call it MANG, but FANG, the word itself has a connotation. It's like as if it's scratching you, right? It's taking away your flesh.
Yeah.
Now there's one more tool comes, ChatGPT actually, which is a danger to Google as well.
GPT absolutely. Disrupting the entire landscape of entire, you can say, job market is being disrupted by GPT now. Yeah. As it will grow in next 1 to 2 years, we'll see chaos in the job market.
Yes.
Perfect. So let's move further before we get hijacked by GPT. All right. So in the next couple of slides, I'll be talking about 9 principles of digital transformation. Okay. These are things which I have captured. Different people would have different perspectives on it. All right. The first set of 6 principles is that we were a disconnected world. So when we were talking about the brick and mortar world, the one characteristic was disconnected. And because it was disconnected, there were quite a few people who were making their living out of it. Whether it was the railway tickets, or it was income tax, or it was so many different things. Just because information was not available, there were a set of service providers who were making their money out of it. From being disconnected, we moved towards a networked world. So like Kamal was just sharing, the data, it was available public, and now it is owned by us. This is a major shift in how things are happening. But yet that data is available on the network. From closed systems, we've moved to open systems. So when we're talking about an Android or an Apple, it is difficult to say whether it is closed or open, but still it is open. Because there are different service providers who are able to write their apps on the Apple platforms, right? Or even Android. Similarly, in the auto sector or whichever. So we're moving from closed economy. Microsoft was a classic closed environment. And Google on the other side was open. So this open took over the closed one. From fixed environment to a fluid environment. So like we were just talking about the MSMEs, wherein there was a fixed way in which manufacturing used to happen. And now it is fluid. Okay. And it is bound to become more fluid as we go further. We used to talk about volume. Now we're talking about value. What is the value that our customer is deriving? That is what defines how successful we can be. The next one is risk. we would get into government jobs because there was less risk. Today, a large number of people are getting into startups because there's more opportunity there. So how many of us here right now are from the startup world?
Actually, I'm starting my own startups right now.
So Gaurav is starting his own. Kamal is already running his own startup. I have been a startup for some time.
Already is in beta phase. We already launched the website, portal and mobile application.
So, perfect. Yeah. So Sugesh is also in the startup space. Charu Datta is also in the startup space, right? So from risk, from being risk averse, we are facing opportunities. This is a major transformation. All right. From a time when Dadi Seth or HLL used to look at everybody as a consumer, to today, when each one of us is a global citizen, this again is a major shift. Then comes principle number 3. Consumer behavior itself has changed. So for this, I will take you through an article which was published by McKinsey in 2020 during the period when pandemic was in its full swing. So here are 10 elements which they spoke about. The first one is, online shopping is here to stay. Today, whether we go up country in the villages or we are in the cosmopolitan cities, everybody is shopping online. Right? And who is driving this is the millennials and high income groups. They are the ones who are leading that space. And third, which is a very interesting phenomena, is that brand switching has become very, very, very easy. So if we would see the past 5-6 years, or at least 3-4 years, there are many new brands which have come up. So the shaving gel that I'm using these days, not the shaving gel, the aftershave. The shaving gel is still from Gillette. But the aftershave that I'm using, that comes from a brand called Ustra, which I don't think existed a couple of years back. So these are the kind of things which are happening. And for creating a brand, availability and value perception are something which are very, very important. If your product is not available, the brand recall will not be there. And if you bring additional value perception, people are ready to pay premium for that. It's not gone are the days of Maruti when people would say, "Kitna deti hai?" Right? So if we look at the share of Maruti in the world has been, at least in India, it has been going down, though the volumes still keep on growing. The other brands have been coming in. That is because the value perception is there. And there have been changes in how they shop. Focus is an essential. So we have one very, very visible change is that of minimalism. Even though there is more money to be spent, we're focusing on minimalistic stuff, even though that is higher quality. And value for money definitely is there. And how they spend their time, that has also been changing. So Netflix, that consumes a lot of time today. And not only Netflix, there are so many other OTT platforms. when we were growing up, there used to be one television in the home, and that used to be Hamara television. Today, each one of us has his own television, the mobile phone. And we don't really like somebody intruding into our personal space. This is a shift. So what that means is, when we are talking to our consumers, we need to talk to them as individuals. We cannot generalize anymore. This is something which is coming with the metaverse, wherein each one of us has our own digital. Earlier, there used to be digital persona. Now there's a digital identity. It become more and more focused. And also there's a change in what people do outside their home. And these consumer shift, it changes with the segments. All right. Now going to the principle number two, discovery is the in thing. What that means, today the consumer is much more engaged than they have ever been in the history. The impact is, from Kirana Wala, we've moved to Blinkit. From utilities, we've gone to self-service portals. There used to be times when we had to stand in queues for long hours to pay the electricity bill, the water bill, the gas pipeline and gas bill and everything. Today, in a matter of seconds, you can pay the bills through online portals. Ticketing and travel agents, they've kind of gone away. Travel portals are there. Again, self-service, though, the consumer is the king. That has been said for a very long time. The customer is the king. That has come of reality now. Retail has given way to online retail. Insurance agents, policy bazaar, advertising agents, self-service on Facebook or Meta. PR agencies giving way to bloggers, vloggers, podcasts. Now, you can have a blogger right up there in the Himalayas who has got millions of subscribers. So it's not that you've got to be in the heart of a bigger city. You can be at the remotest of locations and still become an influencer. The tailor has given way to ready-mades, the H&Ms and Zaras of the world. Government offices, we don't need to go there anymore. Through single window services, we're able to service them. And here, consumer is the king. The consumer is driving all this. And you know what's the principle number one? The principle number one is sales is a dying profession. Before I talk more about it, let me hear from some of you. What do you get out of this when I say sales is a dying profession?
So can I speak on this, Atul?
Yeah, please.
So, yes, I totally agree. Sales is a dying profession. In fact, iska feeler jo hai pichle ek saal se, deir saal se, do saal se aana shuru ho gaya tha. So earlier, what used to happen was that sales was the, you know, major revenue earning division for any company. It still is, no doubt about that. But sales in its own self, ek uska bahut, you know, effort lagta tha, time lagta tha, uske liye bahut sare resources dedicate hote the. But abhi kya hai ki sales is nothing but a outcome of marketing. It's a byproduct of marketing. Aur agar marketing ki baat kare to usme apna sara, chahe wo CRM tool ho gaya, customer relationship management tool ho gaya, automation ho gaya, chahe wo you know, getting behind the right target customer ho gaya, kyunki wo digital se itna aasan ho gaya hai that we exactly know that who do we have to target, you know, in terms of marketing, advertising, promotion, etc. To jab itna kuch ho gaya hai to sales jo hai uska ek automatic byproduct jo hai ban gaya hai. Isliye what we are also seeing in you know, even in medium and big corporates is that sales ke liye jo workforce bhi hai, you know, that is also declining day by day. Iska ek live example ye hai ki कुछ साल पहले हम लोग देखते थे कि कॉल सेंटर पे दे यूज टू बी रियल पीपल, यू नो, कॉल करते थे एयरटेल को या किसी ऑटोमोबाइल कंपनी को या किसी भी और कंपनी को, दे यूज टू बी रियल पीपल. नाउ दैट हैज बीन रिप्लेस्ड बाय ऑटोमेटेड बॉट्स, और उसकी भी जरूरत नहीं पड़ती बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज सो ऑटोमेटेड दैट सेल्स इज नथिंग बट अ बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दैट. वो तो अपने आप ही हो जाती है एक तरह से. जो मेजर फोकस चला गया है वो डिजिटलाइजेशन पे चला गया है, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, डिजिटल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन पे चला गया है, एंड बिल्डिंग दिस इंटायर डिजिटल स्ट्रक्चर फॉर मार्केटिंग एंड कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजमेंट एटसेट्रा. सो दिस इज व्हाट आई फील दैट व्हाई सेल्स इज अ डाइंग प्रोफेशन.
Awesome. Thank you. Thanks, Advait. Anybody else?
On this bit, Atul, I think that sales is probably into the evolution phase now. I will completely agree that the conventional sales guy is not the one that you're looking for. But eventually, if you have to get business, you would need sales. So you would need that guy to transform himself, and probably his insights on understanding the customer behavior and the decision making needs to be incorporated in the system that we are evolving. But somebody who is not able to transition himself into the digital part of the sales is the one who is going to get absolute for sure.
Well, I am kind of 50-50 on what you are saying, Charu. And in the next couple of slides, I'll talk about it. Anybody else?
Yeah,
hi, Jayatu. Who's this?
Sangeeta.
Yeah, Sangeeta.
Yeah, here I also would say that it's not the same in all the industries. For example, I know in the sugar industry, you know, there are several brokers, several agents who are attached to the, directly associated with the mills, you know. So those agents are, they only can do transactions, they get the orders from the mills, and basis that the brokers, sub brokers, they get it. I mean, it is just very, very far away from digitized industry.
Absolutely.
And last point I would like to add. I think it depends. Sales is dying, is a dying profession. It depends upon where exactly you are doing the sales. Because in enterprise level, where you are doing a sales of customization, let's say, you need to go there and like present all those things in front of 10 people, right? You cannot target a single person through marketing and then convince him, because to make that sale, you need to be physically present and do all those things over there, which is required earlier as well. And the sales guys are really good with it. So it depends. And that's what I think.
Yes. So let me share a couple of cases in point. Okay. Kerala is supposed to be the land of black gold. And black gold are the spices. Okay. Earlier, it used to happen that it would be very difficult to kind of standardize the price of the commodity, because people did not know at what price the commodity is being sold in one market, and what are the kind of stocks which are available, what is the kind of demand which is available. Today, it takes around half an hour in the morning to stabilize the rate, because everybody is connected on the mobile phone and they have a fair idea of how much stock is available in which mandi. All right. So that the value that the tout used to bring in, or the agent used to bring in, that has kind of got diminished. Similarly, the job of a B2B or a corporate sales guy was that of a consultant. Invariably, he would go and educate the customer. Today, that education is available online. Whether, yes, Advait is talking about travel agents have vanished. Yeah. So whether it is white papers being published by the big consulting firms, or it is the product sheets which are published by the product manufacturers, or it is the case studies of different solution providers, all that is public data which is available. So the consumer, he does his study. Remember, I said discovery is the in thing. So it is the customer who does the discovery himself. Today, past 5 or 6 mobile phones that I've bought, I have not consulted anybody at all. Because I know the kind of mobile phone which I want. I simply go to Amazon, place an order, and it gets delivered. So just taking this conversation further, this is what anybody in sales would know the term lead, right? The one on the left-hand side, this is the traditional lead life cycle, if I would say. It starts with awareness, then interest, then consideration, then intent to buy, then evaluation of various options. And after that comes the purchase decision. So on the right-hand side, awareness is what is called as lead generation. Interest, consideration, intent, and evaluation, all that is what is called as lead nurturing. Purchase is called sales. This is traditionally how the life cycle of a lead. Now let us see something interesting here. Earlier, the awareness and interest piece, that was in the domain of marketing. And right from consideration up to purchase, it was the domain of sales. Now what has happened is awareness, interest, consideration, intent, and evaluation to a very great extent falls under the domain of marketing. Whether that is in person, offline, or online, or digital, all that put together is marketing. And only the last piece, which is evaluation to purchase, that is what comes under the purview of sales.
Nice articulation.
Right. Thanks, Jayatu. And if we see the marketing piece, a lot of it has been automated. We're able to track the behavior of the customers. We know how much is he engaging with us. We know at what points is he engaging with us. We also know at what points he is getting dissociated with us. Right? So this is why I'm saying that sales is a dying profession. Till the time transactions happen between a buyer and a seller, sales will continue to be there. But the importance of sales or the level of conversation which a sales guy is doing, that has altered, that has transformed. So maybe we could also say that marketing is an evolving function instead of saying that sales is a dying function. So now it is again open for your reflections. What did you get out of this conversation so far? This time, let us again have 3 people share. Fastest finger first.
Yeah, you rightly said, like, marketing is growing. And on the other hand, people, like, you rightly said, like, in websites and by doing white papers and demonstrating the product online, right? So a lot of work for which sales guys were doing has been already automated. So, and the consumer behavior has also changed at some extent where they are looking and searching for the things on their own on their own needs, right? So, yeah, these things make sense to me. Thanks.
Thank you. Thanks. Anybody else? So I'll give you a case in point. So once I was listening to the CTO of Policy Bazaar. Okay. And what he shared was that they are using data mining and the telecom bots for their sales processing. Now, they've got the data of the person, the name, his age, the policy that he's got. They also know when is the policy expiring. They also know when is the next policy due. And they just put all that data together and feed a text in which that data gets fit in. And the person gets a message, whether it is voice message or it is an SMS or it is nowadays WhatsApp or an email. That, dear Atul Puri, your policy is due on this date. This is the premium pending. If you don't pay it, then this is the penalty, whatsoever, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Earlier, this work, hundreds of agents sitting in a call center would do it. Now, they can push this message to thousands, millions of people at one point in time with no clash, with 100% accuracy. You don't need a sales guy there at all. Anybody else? Yes, Sangeeta, what you're saying is sort of a mail merge. So what Microsoft spoke as mail merge, they are using the same piece. Anybody else? So ya to sab samajh mein aa gaya ya kuch samajh mein nahi aaya.
No, that's correct, Atul, actually. Most of the things are depending on data right now. All the marketing effort is depending on data and analysis only. And it
absolutely
makes a lot of efforts is reduced towards sales side. Even in my company, we do rarely sales. We just focus on certain data only, that's it, right? So the effort is very less from sales point of view. And many nowadays, we have a lot of virtual tools. Even meetings are getting reduced, actually, right now, you know. So with we can go with video calls and other thing, right? So that is also getting reduced. So sales effort is definitely getting reduced day by day. And it is transforming more towards art, towards marketing, actually. So more focus is towards more of our marketing side, like how we are going to do strategies, how we're going to data analysis, and how we're going to present to our client based on his customized requirement, basically.
Beautiful. So if you guys agree to this, please write in the chat box, data is king.
Data is king, and value driven is by data. We should know how to drive value from it.
Absolutely.
That is where my startup jumps in. We call it Data Blair. While I talk to my companies, the customers, I call them like data is new oil and Data Blair is fuel refinery.
Awesome.
Actually, we started one startup that is aggregating sellers who supply spare parts for the industries, actually. So that is what we are doing right now. So we are aggregating a lot of data in terms of spare parts used in different manufacturing industries. So we will do analytics at that side. So when the industry needs procurement process, we are making it easy for spare parts.
Perfect. All right. So let's move further. All right. So how do you transform your business? First piece is shift from speaking to listening. Because when you are listening, your customer is giving you a lot of signals. Move from expenditure to investment. And don't invest in fancy cars. Invest in your customer. That will pay real great dividends. And my way or highway to customer's way. Because it is the customer who pays your bills. Does that make sense?
Definitely. Hello?
Yes, Atulji. But Atulji, one thing.
See, in a B2C level,
yeah. Okay,
whatever you are telling is 100%, you know, correct. Okay. But when it is coming to enterprise level sales,
yeah.
Okay. Whatever you do, ultimately, you know, enterprise need a, you know, build a trust before going for purchase anything, right? So obviously, sales guy plays a vital role in that.
So let me give you one sentence which you would like. Okay. If they like you, they will listen to you. If they like you, they will listen to you. If they trust you, they will do business with you.
That's right.
All right.
Yes.
Now, how do you build that trust and how soon you build that trust is the game changer.
Yeah.
Now, for building that trust, you need not be there on their head, sitting in their office all the time.
Mm-hmm.
That can happen by feeding them. So the first thing what I've said here is speaking to listening. Listen to the customer. So how many of you are married?
Oh, yes. You are now testing the listening power, I think.
Okay. If you are married and if you are the man, then you hear this a number of times every week. Tum sunte nahi ho. Right? So that is what our customer is also telling us. You don't listen. Because we are so eager to tell about what do I have? What can I offer? What can our company offer? So in Jaitu's case, my ERP can do this. Customer says, I just want this. Yes, but I have this.
Yeah. You know, thing is, Atulji, in the ERP segment, okay, enterprise level solution segment, if you're not able to understand clients' challenges or problem, it's very, it's a very solution-oriented, solution. I mean, you should have a solution-oriented approach. Otherwise, it's very difficult to sell ERP, right? So you need to know the customer challenges or difficulties, then only you'll be able to, make the solution, right? So
See, the interesting piece is when we are into solution selling, one of the premise is that the customer does not know. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now the market has changed and the customer knows. The customer is educated. The customer has other sources to get information. So information is not very expensive now.
Yes, that's right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yes.
So earlier, information was a big thing because the customer did not have access to information. He would listen to us and he would pay a premium for it. Today, information is available in plenty. So now to create that value, we need to go beyond information. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So now what is that? That is where the secret sauce lies.
Yeah, let me add something to it, Puriji.
Please.
Give me 2 minutes. Huh? So I have done this.
So 2 minutes cost 1 lakh rupees.
Yes, I will give that to you. So the information that I'm giving, it worth 10 lakh rupees.
Okay.
Yes. So you are saying listen to your customer. And sir is saying that customer is at the enterprise level, right? So when we are going to ERP and we are selling those things. So I have figured out this thing, like we have the product. You are saying to don't talk about your product too much, right? Yes, that's true. We don't need to talk about our product that much, but we need to make a framework a framework where there are strategies. Like at the objective layer, we will understand the objective, why you even need the ERP, right? The customer, because they are a bunch of people who will make the decision come true. And maybe they have some innovations in their head also for their particular industry. So we need to hear that as well. And if we add something from our experiences over there, that is where they gain the trust. And that is where the sales happen. Right? This is what I believe.
Absolutely. All right.
Add to what Jaitu Paul was saying, you know, so he is into enterprise resource planning, ERP basically. Now, ERP in itself is, you know, is in the area of digital transformation, I would say. Right.
That's right.
And in order to provide these big enterprises and medium enterprises a very up-to-date digital transformation, you know, enterprise resource planning, you know, ERP companies themselves have to continuously go through an updated digital transformation platform, because digital transformation is, you know, evolving at the speed of light every day. So, you know, like ERP mein aapko, you know, you have to understand the customer experience. There is a lot of understanding of data analytics, cloud computing, even mobility for that matter, right? So, usme aapka transportation ka to aa hi jata hai bahut bada. So, you know, as an ERP business also, I think the best solution any ERP business would be able to offer to any big or medium scale enterprise would be dependent upon how quick an ERP company is also able to pivot themselves to the daily updating digital transformation needs. So, so I think even ERP, you know, every industry, you know, has to go through that constant evolution day in and day out in order to be relevant to these big companies and even the medium companies. So I think that is also a very important piece which we can consider.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. So do we move forward, please?
Can I speak?
Yeah, Mayur, half a minute. Yeah, please.
ERP cost is quite high for medium enterprises. I'm in a manufacturing and industries, so working with so many. My marketing is only with, my sales is only with the people who are small scale industries or medium, even tiny medium scale industries. ERP costs and maintaining the ERP staff is so high that, you know, it will take another 10, 15 years to come into reality.
So Mehta Saab, my 2 cents for this is, if the returns of your investment are far higher than the investment, then you would end up investing in that.
The All real right. challenge is the manpower the industries is facing right now. Who can handle the ERP as well as the use of ERP? Because still the decision makers are of old school of management.
So that is exactly why we need digital transformation. So digital transformation is shift in the mindset. All right. It is not the tool set. If you have the tool set and you don't have the right mindset, you'll not be able to use the tools.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And also ERP is not, ERP nowadays is coming with a very user-friendly way. So non-technical guys, technical person can handle easily.
So I think Jaitu and Mayur, please have a conversation one-on-one later on. We need to push on. We're getting late.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you. Thanks for your inputs, please. All right. Now let's move on to the business frameworks. Now, this is the framework in which all of us have been living, which is called business by chance. The business begins by inheriting it from your parents by courtesy. The experience, so somebody said that he spent around 23 years in the corporate space, in finance space. All right. Because of this, the only choice he has is to get into a business which is related to finance. Or then there is a new trend which is coming in. So when lockdown happened, there were many people who got into manufacturing of masks or trading of masks and sanitizers. And then, of course, my hot favorite is pink slip. Your existing employer says that he can't afford you anymore, and he says thank you to you. And then next day, you are a business owner. This is how a business begins. Then comes a growth phase where a company is formed. You start looking for customers, and then we continue to do sale every day. And then we end up overlooking certain aspects of our business, and then comes struggle. Receivables start mounting, manpower challenges come in, working capital challenges come in, and margins keep on becoming thin every day. And finally, the business collapses. Now, today the topic is not this, so that's why I'll not dwell further into it. Then there is another kind of a business which is called business by design. Here we start with the design of the business, have a great foundation of the business, develop it further, and finally diversify it, wherein either we sell it or expand it or get into new territories. And this is how we keep on growing the business. Now, I also promise you that we will be talking about three secrets of leveraged businesses. So this business by design is a leveraged business, which is an ever evolving and growing business. So let's see what are these three secrets of a leveraged business. The first one is to be a leveraged quadrant player. Okay. All of you who follow finance would definitely be aware of what is called as ESBI. ESBI are four quadrants. E stands for employees. So when you're an employee, you are selling your time for money. The next level is where you are a self-employed person. Here, depending on the contract or the job that you got, you're making the money. 90% of people, or more than 90% of people on this planet, fall on the left-hand side. They're either employees or self-employed. And they control less than 10% of the wealth. They work alone and they are selling time for money. And then there is the right-hand side, which is B or I. B is business owners and I is investors. The business owners, they have learned the craft of leverage. They leverage various resources, time, energy, money, connections, technology, all this they leverage. And they count their success in terms of turnover. And then there is another set of people who are investors who make a lot of money passively, wherein their money is working for them. They evaluate or they value their success in terms of dividend. So just around, data says there are around 3% people who are on the right-hand side. And they control more than 90% of the wealth on this planet. And what differentiates them is they leverage their resources and they use systems to make more money. They keep on growing every day. All right. Now, the first secret is that we must get into the leverage quadrant, which is the top right. Secret number two, it is weave business engagement. So here at the bottom end is a tea seller or simply a seller. You need tea. The tea seller gives you tea, you pay him money, you don't even know who's he, you don't know whether you'll ever meet him after that. So there's a simple transaction which is happening. Many of you who are in the business networking platforms, you would be aware of these two terms called hunter and farmer. A hunter is somebody who goes, picks a deal, cracks a deal, comes back, and is highly successful. And then there is another set of people who are called farmers. They nurture relationships, they keep on growing them, and then that translates into business. And I'm introducing to you a term which you may have heard for the very first time, which is called Weaver. So if we look at the value addition, the tea seller has least value in this hierarchy. Hunter has slightly more value. Farmer has even more. And Weaver has the highest value. The product that Weaver has, that gets most appreciation. Here, the terms that you see in the bracket are PKST. So T seller, T is only the transaction. The hunter has a skill and a transaction. The farmer has knowledge, skill, and transaction. So the farmer knows what kind of crop will go in that soil. How much water does their crop need? When they need to weed it? All that stuff, all that knowledge combined with the skill and the transaction gets them the results. When it comes to weaver, a weaver also has one more thing added, which is called as the process. If this is something which is interesting, which you heard for the first time, please write in the chat box Weaver, W-E-A-V-E-R. Thanks, Atul. And then let me take you through the third secret, which is step up the ladder. So here I'll give you the example of, ideally I would have liked to give it, the animation would have worked here. At the bottom is sale, okay? So let us look at the case of a street vendor, especially a vegetable vendor, a greengrocer. He would need to sell the product the same day. If at all that day is a rainy day, his stock will get wasted. So if he does not have the holding power, he'll not be able to make a lot of money on it. The second level of maturity is a referral. So like there is a honeybee which goes from one flower to another flower to another flower. In that process, it helps with the pollination. And that in turn helps in creating of fruits or vegetables. All right. And the third piece is networking. Networking is like farming. A farmer will prepare the land, sow the seeds, weed, put the fertilizer, give enough water, have enough sunshine, guard the plot, and then one fine day he would cut the crop. And then the fourth one, the highest level over here is leverage. Here I would give the example of Reliance. Reliance, as you would know, they started off with cloth, trading of cloth. And then they kept on leveraging the various resources that they had, the stock market and the technology. Today they are in hydrocarbons, petroleum retail, Reliance retail, media business, geo platforms. To the extent that during lockdown, when the entire world was struck with the pandemic, in a span of 32 days, Mukesh Ambani's Jio platforms, they picked up billions of dollars from across the globe. That is leverage, my friends. And these are the kind of businesses we need to create or aspire to create if we really want to be viable in the digital transformation world. And now, if this is an aha moment for you, please write in the chat box, Jio. So we've got a couple of Jio guys. All right. So when the going gets tough, the tough get going. The era which we are going through right now, this is the time when the tough have to get going. This is the time when we need to get into digital transformation. If we don't do that, we'll go belly up very soon. So putting things in perspective, business is going through tectonic shifts. Digital transformation is the new lubricant. Three secrets of the leveraged business are: be the leverage quadrant player, weave business engagement, and step up the hierarchy of sales. So now it is again open for a quick discussion. Three of you, fastest finger first. What did you get out of it? Hello? Tick-tick one.
Is it free?
What is free? There is nothing free in this world, my friend.
Okay.
Yeah. So what did you get out of this conversation? The three secrets. Being in the leverage quadrant, we business engagement, and the hierarchy of sales.
One question I had.
Yeah, please.
What after that I quadrant, like investor quadrant, what after that?
C quadrant.
Seek.
C.
C.
Yeah.
Okay. What to C?
C is contribution.
Okay.
The highest level of engagement, what you can have is contribution.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Give back.
Give back to the society.
That is the largest thing that we can have.
Mm-hmm.
Whether you talk about Mahatma Gandhi, you talk about Gautam Buddha, you talk about Nanak, you talk about Mother Teresa,
mm-hmm.
all of them are known because they've been, or you talk about Jesus Christ,
mm-hmm.
they are there because they gave. They yes. gave.
Okay.
They never ever had a challenge.
Mm-hmm. Does that make sense? And to reach out that quadrant, do we need to follow these four quadrants?
Today, the conversation is digital transformation.
Yes.
We are not into contribution. We are into earning. Don't take me away from the route, okay?
Okay.
We all need contribution from you.
Yeah. So this session which we are creating is out of contribution.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So what did you get out of it? 1 minute more. Patanjali, session abhi baki hai, mere dost. All right. So if you're not sharing much, then we move further. So at this stage, you got two choices. The first choice is continue as before. Take a cab, go home if you are at home, and continue doing what you are doing. Second option that you have is cause digital transformation in wherever you are. If you don't transform today, you are dead beat tomorrow. So design brings workability. It also brings a state change.
Absolutely.
And this is how your customers look like if you take care of them. Dan Kennedy wrote a book by the name Make Them Laugh and Take Their Money. So before you contribute, you need to have that money to contribute, right? Today the topic is to make money.
Got it,
right? So are you committed for a state change? If yes, write in the chat box, yes. And for those who are not writing a yes for you, the session is over. You may please go. Thank you for your time. Let's meet some other time somewhere else. Only 5-6 yeses. 7. All right. So while you're deciding whether it's a yes or a no, let's move further. We are starting with a program called Unfold Your Greatness. Not starting, we've scheduled it later this month. And I invite you to participate in that. So what we've discussed so far is that our world is at the cusp of a major and permanent digital transformation. You need to take those calls right now. Yeah, Patanjali, you want to ask something? Patanjali, please go ahead. You'll need to unmute yourself. Okay, we'll come to you later, Patanjali, I think. Right? So Unfold Your Greatness is a program which is scheduled for 28th and 29th of January. And this is something which will give you a lot of insights and actionable items for causing digital transformation in your business. You could be from any industry, be it marketing, logistics, art vendor, vendor development, any of them. This will be worthwhile for you. The participants, as I said, you can be from any industry, manufacturing, trading, training, international business. This program is for you if you are looking for new possibilities in this year. If you intend to reposition your business in the year 2023. If you are looking to launch new products. If you want to start leveraging technology for your business. If you are committed to get your business on autopilot. And if you've done enough and you want to delegate your responsibilities, then this program is for you.
Atulji, it will be offline, right?
Yes, it will be offline. It will be in Delhi, in Gurgaon.
Okay.
And I invite you to book the tickets right now.
Sanji, I already, you know, Advait already, you know, informed me, but, you know, unfortunately, I'll be in Africa that time.
No worries. We'll create another one. So, okay, in that case, you send me the tickets, we'll do it in Africa. All right. So, here's Mithlesh. Mithlesh is one of our participants of the previous program. So he did this in 2019 with me. He was, in fact, the first one to do this program. Okay, especially the design your business piece. What he got out of it is that he says, we clearly understand our strength areas now. We are able to emphasize more on planning before execution to reduce mistakes. And we are able to systematize our process. What that means is the wastage has reduced. The effectiveness has increased. At that point in time, they had an office only in Delhi. Today, they have an office in Delhi, another one in Kandla in Gujarat, and also another one in Shenzhen in China. Yeah. And they have tied up with another company in Singapore. All right. This is the kind of profound impact this business has had. So this program has had. So Mithlesh, he's from Delhi. Then we have Sharda and Krishna Merchant. They are partners in Rustic Blends, which is a fashion startup from Mumbai. So what they say that it's a step-by-step systematic and scientific approach. If implemented the way it should be, gives dynamic results. As a result of this, in the first 2 weeks itself, they closed an order. And this order was with a company from Africa, which had presence in multiple airports across the globe, without meeting the person in person. All right. And then Mr. Satya, no, okay, he is not Mr. anymore. He is Dr. now. Dr. Satya Gupta, he is also going to be a speaker in the current session. He is a philanthropist. He was the managing director, the first managing director of RailTel in India. He's worked with British Telecom. And right now he is heading Blue Town India. He is also running an organization called DigiGaon Job Factory, wherein they are creating jobs for women folks in rural India.
Wow.
Okay. He will be speaking on Blue Ocean Strategy this time. All right. So these are some of the people who have benefited from this in the past. The facilitators for this program, one would be me. I come with 26 plus years of experience, have been a sales guy in the corporate sales, different industries. I've traveled far and wide. I have also created two business models. One is the exponential growth framework and the leverage model. I've also published two books on similar topics. And I'll be giving this entire piece during these 2 days. The second faculty is Dr. Satya Gupta. He is also known as NGN Guru, which is Next Generation Networks. He is the chairperson of Blockchain for Productivity India. Okay. He is also on the board of ITU, which is International Telecom Union, and a number of other platforms in the telecom space, in and is connected to who's who, especially in the government and PSU space in India. Okay. A very humble person, and he will be talking on Blue Ocean Strategy. The third expert, he is Dhruv Khanna. Dhruv Khanna is an ex-IBM. Okay, he is currently the founder and CEO of Data Resolve Technologies and will be talking on data security. His startup was incubated by IIT Kharagpur. And they have raised 3 rounds of funding till date. Then we also have Advait. Advait, would you like to tell something about yourself?
Yes, Atul, if I can come back in, you know, in a minute about myself.
Okay, done.
Yeah.
So for during that minute, we'll talk about Mohit Jain. Mohit Jain is an e-commerce expert. He's the co-founder of Upriver, a company which helps brands in listing on Amazon and other marketplaces. Okay. They are among the top runners as far as partners with Amazon are concerned. Okay. So this, if you would see, none of us are trainers per se. We are successful business owners, and we are sharing with you how we went through the digital transformation journey, and that is what we are going to give to you.
Super.
All right. The curriculum, business transformation trends, the purpose of your business. See, the purpose of your business is the foundation of your business. If you don't have a great foundation, your business will never stand. It will collapse. Then we're talking about Blue Ocean Strategy. Digital transformation. What are the building blocks of digital transformation? Unfold your greatness. This is where I'll be taking you through the summaries of a few books, which will make a lot of impact on your business. Advait will be talking about curated communities. What, why, and how of community management. He'll also take you through some case studies. Because in the digital world, you need to have a community, a healthy community around your business. Content marketing universe, different kinds of content. How do you create those? How do you cultivate those? Why do you need content? What kind of content is required for which kind of an engagement? Social media nuances, data security, marketing automation, win on Amazon, productivity tools, the road ahead, hiring an agency, what you need to look at when you're hiring an agency. How do you build a team which is ready for digital transformation? See, digital transformation are not just two words. They are a complete universe in themselves. And unless you alter the fabric of your company, it will not work. This is a 2 days program. You will get to network with these people. And at the end of the program, this is the kind of a photograph that will click. So how many of you would like to come for this kind of a photograph?
I would like to, but...
No problem. We'll sort out something. We'll create something else. All right.
Yeah.
So this is happening on the 28th of January, morning 10 o'clock to 6:30 on 29th from morning 10 a.m. to actually it'll go to 6:30 or maybe more.
It's in Delhi, right?
Yes, it is in Delhi, in Gurgaon. Okay.
So
this kind of a program from INSEAD or ISB would cost you anything from 2 lakhs to 12 lakh rupees. And you are getting it at only 17,999, all inclusive, inclusive of the taxes. We're sharing the Paytm link with you. If you're interested, you can please pay it right away. Or if you got any concerns, you can reach out to Advait. I'll share his number also with you in some time. Yeah, Gaurav, you're coming?
I have the issue with the dates and location, actually. I'm in Hyderabad right now. So
just one ticket away?
No, it's not about timing. We have some other thing going on. Marriage is there, actually.
No worries. Yeah, marriage is important. Yours or somebody else's?
Come. Hyderabad, you're coming sometime? Hyderabad?
Yeah, we'll come.
Then it's fine.
All right. And then let me share something, another interesting piece. So this gentleman, his name is Jerry Almeida. Okay. He has constituted an award called Rex Karamvir Award, which has been functional for past around 20 years. Okay. He will be the keynote speaker who will be there for the last session. So 29th evening, he'll be there for the networking session. Okay. You will get an opportunity to meet him in person. That we are not charging you for that. The venue is V Club at Gurgaon, which is a luxurious full-service club in the heart of the city. We really want you to have a great experience. That is why we chose this kind of a venue. It could have been, we were toying it that we could have made it slightly more economical and maybe do it in one of the co-working spaces. But then we thought that as business owners, you deserve some great experience. That is why we're doing it here. What all is included is high tea, lunch. We don't expect you to buy the lunch when you're coming for the program. From Jerry Almeida. V Club will be the conference setup. Business networking. The last session will be business networking, wherein we'll invite more people from eGrowth and otherwise. You'll also get the study material. And this is inclusive of GST. 17999. Do you want something else? Okay, so let's make it even better. If you book it today, you'll be paying only 15999. The Paytm link is already shared in the chat box. Advait has just shared his number as well. Okay. Any questions? Hello.
Any plan for near future? But this time I'll be missing that.
No worries. We'll plan it again. Definitely.
Okay.
See, we can always look at doing it online as well, but the impact will not be as good as it will be in person.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. So we will do it again, definitely.
Sure, sir.
Yeah. Anybody else? Gaurav, Preeta?
Not this, on the date is the issue, actually.
Okay, done.
So it's not possible this time, sir. Sir, there will be continuous. Will there be any continuous update on your sessions later? So that we can.
You will be on our mailing list, and you'll get an email. Definitely whitelist that mail so that it ends up in your mailing mail rather than getting into the spam. And we'll keep you informed. Where are you based, Preeta?
Sir, I'm at Bangalore, sir.
All right. So Bangalore, Hyderabad, two locations we've got. So Jaitu, you have, are you guys colleagues? No. Fantastic. So we've got two people from Bangalore. We can probably do it at Bangalore then.
Yeah, that's what.
Let's fix up a date and we'll do it there.
Yeah.
All right. Who else? Okay, so there is another. So if you got any questions, you can please reach out to Advait. The number is 99588-99270.
Advait, your introduction is pending still. One minute.
Yes.
Yeah. So I was waiting for that. So yes. So I will be, one of the facilitators in this program of 28th and 29th on digital transformation. Now, just a very brief background about me. I have helped brands and companies to develop digital communities around their brands with the purpose of increasing their brand to consumer engagement. So a few brands which I have worked for are ITC, where I was there for about 6 years. I was taking care of their marketing for food products and cigarettes. And I also, ventured on my own for about 2.5 years. It was again a brand to consumer agency, BTL and ATL both. Jispe digital ka humne kaam thoda us time shuru kar diya tha because, that time the world was moving slightly towards the second generation of digital transformation. This was back in 2015-16. And I've also worked with Amway Corporation, where I was heading their marketing for the entire north of the country. Now, Amway depends on community building and community development. So, 2020 mein jab lockdown aaya tha, we shifted online almost overnight. And that was one of the very important key factors that, Amway was one of the companies during that time, which was still registering a lot of growth. So we had completely transformed our community from offline to online. And, I have been instrumental in building digital communities to the tune of lakhs and lakhs of people for many brands. So, that is what I will be offering on the workshop, that how can we leverage to build digital communities, which will enable us to lower our costs, marketing costs, and at the same time, enable us to reach to more and more people at the same time, be it from any industry, B2C, B2B, recruitment, FMCG, B2C. So any sort of industry has the capacity to build communities around it. So that is what my offer would be on, during the workshop.
Sure. Advait, just one question, out of the things, out of yes. the... See, this you worked in ITC for cigarette.
Yes.
So ITC cigarette, do they need branding or anything, or it is legal?
So it is not allowed because it is a tobacco product. Similarly for liquor products, branding is not allowed, but market research is allowed. So market research ke time pe we would try to build a lot of communities. And we would try to reach out.
I suggest you have this conversation offline.
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Done. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so here's a gift for all of you. Please send me a mail on atul@egro.org and I'll be glad to share the soft copy of my book, Golf Mastering Business Success. This is in honor of the time that you've contributed today.
Superb, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you for your gift. That it will be really great to have and read.
Absolutely, yeah. So thanks a lot for your time. We'll be in touch with you. We are going to have a similar session on Thursday, same time. So if there are some of your colleagues or friends who missed it, please invite them to join us. And if you want to come again, there'll be a different conversation, different energy. Looking forward to see you again.
Sure, sir.
All right.
So Thursday ka link mere ko thoda bhej dijiye. Now
link same hoga, we'll mail it to you.
Yeah, yeah. Sure.
Okay.
Sure. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Bye.